Welcome to our Power Project tutorials. For more resources, including a downloadable manual, select the link below.
So let's talk about adding tasks. If you look on page 30 in your manual, there's the first list of activities I'm going to have you to add. You'll notice in this left column, there's milestones, design, procurement, general conditions, site work, substructure. We're just going to manually type these in, and you'll notice that if I select milestones, this is where I add them in. Once again, my project outline has all of the headings in it, but if I add activities in this screen, it's going to add them actually to that project. So if I want to add activities to the milestones section of my outline, I'm going to type on milestones and then just add the activities in here, and they will be assigned to that milestone. And I'm going to make a duration of 0. And ASTA will automatically recognize that that activity is a milestone. I'm going to do the same thing with substantial completion. Make it a 0 duration. So it will also be a milestone. You can see that under design. I'm going to go down here to design and add an activity for prepare final design. Here's my procurement. One of the nice features about this is this allows you to organize and enter your activities one group at a time. And particularly when I'm working with a group of field staff, superintendent, so forth, to be able just to isolate one small group of activities at a time makes it much easier to focus and concentrate on getting just that group of activities together. So under general conditions, mobilization, I've got trailer setup and fencing, and I've got another activity for final clean. I'm going to put my durations in there, and I put a D after it just so that ASTA knows that I'm doing days, and makes things a little easier for it. Then under site work, survey and staking, excavate and grade. Kind of went out of order there, but there's my survey and staking. And I've got 2 days there, my final clean or excavate and grade. I've got 7 days under substructure, layout and grade pad, underground utilities. Form core footings. So I'm adding these activities throughout my in each group. That's one way of adding activities, is select a section in your outline and just manually enter activities. I can also, I go into my structure, I can add activities by just clicking and dragging over here in the bar chart area. So if my next activity on page 31 is structural steel for 5 days, I can click on that activity and then come over here and type structural steel, roof, joist, and deck, 5 days. Once again, I'm going to do this way, just adding the activity. And I'm going to add another one for exterior framing for 8 days. Notice the little yellow box as I'm dragging shows me my 8-day duration. This is for my exterior framing. 5, 10, and 5. I'm going to do my next 3. 5, 10, and 5. And this is my door. I've been able to add activities just by manually entering them in the outline structure, or you can see I click and drag and it also adds activities. I'm going to take my exterior activities. I entered in the wrong outline section, so I can cut, right? I highlighted the activities, hit cut, come down to my exteriors, and I paste them and I put them back in the right place. There's several different ways to move them around, but that's probably one of the easiest.
Thanks for watching our tutorial. Don't forget to share, like, and subscribe to our channel. Please leave comments.